So yeah, my name is, as I said, Jose Garcia. I'm working in the Android team since the beginning of 2017. So I'm going to talk about the auspicious considerations in this session. That is basically meaning how we can use the Android application in order to show data in the map. So, you know, the idea is to, we have different resources that can be listed in a map. So one of them can be the target entity instance, you know, that you can design a target entity type to record, to collect the GPS coordinates. Also, you can capture coordinates with enrollments, with events, with data elements and attributes. You know, you can define a data element or an attribute that is which type, which value type is coordinate, okay, and also the odd unit. We are going to see how we can use these concepts in the DHS2, how we can use them in the Android application. So basically the two main data coordinates that we can collect in the DHS2, at least that makes sense for Android, are polygons and points. Okay, so polygons, we basically is a representation of a polygon in a map, an area that is defined with several coordinates representing the latitude and the longitude. Okay, and then we have points. Well, and also to say that the polygon coordinates are not like supported yet by data elements and attributes. Okay, only this makes sense only for the, well, makes sense. This is only supported for TIs, enrollments and events. While the points at the end is just a single coordinate with the latitude and longitude. So in the Android application, mobile application, we support both kind of coordinates, polygons and points. So basically, how can we set up this in the DHS? So if we want to track coordinates at the target entity instance level, so we need to go to a target entity type. I'm going to show you in a moment in a demo. But before, let me go through the slides. We need to go to the track entity type. And then in the track entity type, in this case, we are using the person. There is a field that is called feature type. So basically there we need to select the point as a feature type. Okay, and then the point or polygon. Okay, these are the options. And then when we are recording a COVID case, so we can like specify always for collecting data, the current location, if we click on this button over here, or then we can set up any location that we want in a map, just clicking in this button over here. Okay. This for the tracked entity instances, the same for the enrollments. The enrollments in this case, we need to go to the program itself because enrollment, of course, all of you know that belongs to a program. So, and in the enrollment details, we will see this field here that is a feature type and we have to select point or polygon. And then it's the same, we can during data entry, then we are going to have in the enrollment screen of Android, we are going to have a field that is enrollment coordinates. And here we can represent what is the current location or select any location in a map. For events here, that a use case can be where the person is when the event is being recorded, collected. So in this case, it will be in the program stage level. In the details. So there is also a feature type. So here we need to select this point or polygon. So if some of these are active, so then we will, yes?
Can I share a question from Slack? The question is, when would you choose a point or a polygon?
So, well, it really depends on the use case. So for instance, well, probably if you want to show a location of a household or where the person is, where a person lives, where the village, where the location of the village is, maybe you normally want to use a point as the GPS coordinate, and a polygon maybe is just for defining an area. In mind that you need to conduct an investigation in a particular area because there are many COVID cases or there are many malaria cases. It's quite useful in surveillance scenarios. So in that case, you will say, okay, I would like to define my focus area on this particular, I know, geographically, area, and then you can select like the different GPS points in the map as well. For that, so yeah, I would say that is the most common use cases for focus investigations. And I don't know if I has answered the question.
I think that's okay, Jose. Thank you. If not, please send the follow-up questions in either Slack or the chat, Johan. Thank you.
Okay, so this is for program stages. And then for data elements and attributes, in this case, I have defined one that is location of the village. That can be, but as I said before, one use case can be where the patient has traveled. Okay. And then you can have like a collection of points that can be an attribute or a data element. It's more or less the same, depending on your design. And that you can specify with them like where the patient has been. Went in the in the last week or in the last month, in the last year. So as a use case for this. So in this case, you need to mark the location of the village, which value type of coordinate value type, and then in this case this represents an enrollment. So you can see here the value of the attribute, and in this case we are really accepting points, not volumes. Okay. And then and for that elements is the same. And the last one is the R unit attribute. Okay, so you know that we can define also an attribute that which value type is R unit, and in this case it will represent like during data entry you will have a drawdown like this. In this case, it represents the Sierra Leone geographically, in which you have to select first the district, the chiefdoms, and or the district or regions, the chiefdoms, till the facility level. Okay, and you have to select one by one. So you will select the district, and then they will show the different regions under that district, and then you select a region and will show up the different chiefdoms under that region. Okay. So if I'm going, let me go now to the HS2 just to do a quick recap of all this. So in this case, I am with my, if I'm going to the track entity type, you go to person, and you will see that the feature type is selected as point. So so you can select as a polygon, but in this case, my case is point over here. So this means that whenever I am like this, we have a program which track entity type is person. So you have the option of collecting the coordinates for that particular TI, okay? So this is for track entity types. Now let me go to the program view. And we're going to, I guess you have, all of you have access to this program, the contract registration and follow-up. So we are going to do the exercise based on this program, okay? So if you click here, okay, and then you will see that in the enrollment details, you have also the feature type over here. So this means that you could also collect GPS points at the moment of the enrollment of the person, but as part of the program, not the track entity instance, okay, but part of the program. And then what, as I said before, we also can collect coordinates at the event level. Okay, so in this case, I have just select one of these symptoms. And in the symptoms, you can see here that we also have feature type So it's been set up as point. So we can also collect now the GPS point at the moment of the creating an event. Okay, and also, I have defined an attribute. Let me cancel this. Okay, that is the location of the village. Okay, and basically this attribute. Let me find location. the value type is coordinate. Okay, so it will also collect a GPS point. Okay, so let me, this is regarding the configuration, but now how can I use this in the in my Android app? So let me go back to my presentation. And basically, these are the different features that we can visualize in a map in Android. So we can visualize track identity instances, we can visualize enrollments, events, data element or attributes. This is new from 2.4, but not our unit. Okay, for your unit, if you are collecting, because an attribute or data, an attribute is, which is a value type of an attribute is an our unit, we will be able to collect the data as an our unit, but we are not going to be able to show that our unit in a map. Okay, this is not, hasn't been implemented in another application yet. Okay, so so now I think that, well, you have all the options in the presentation, but I'm going to run a demo and then you can see the presentation whenever you want. So let me, okay, hopefully you all can see this. I am showing the Android application now. If you cannot see it, let me know.
Yes, we can.
Okay, thank you, Jaime. So I am going to, as I said before, our program for doing the exercise is going to be this one, the contact registration and follow-up. So I click on this one. Okay, we have a list of TIs here. Okay, so let me filter by, and I see this going a bit slow now. Okay, but let me filter by the enrollment date. Okay, we have kind of a delay with screen. So I'm going to share the screen again. Sorry about the technical difficulties. So because let me, I'm going to close this. Okay, let's see if now it comes a disaster. So I'm going to select the last month. No, it's going well. Let's see. Okay, so now I have selected the last month and now it's showing me only the TIs of the last month. And now you see that we have a button here that is to represent the TIs in a map. So I click here. Going to, it's faster in the in another application, but why is it on the screen? Okay, so this is the TIs that are in the map, so I can like move through them, and also you see here that we are going to have like a carousel in the bottom, so and I can use that carousel to move between the different. Between the different TIs, okay. So, and you can navigate quite easily using the carousel, moving to the right or to the left, okay. And here we are going to only to show this going to only to show the TIs that has basically coordinates. Otherwise, we cannot represent the minimap, of course. So we have also like the different buttons over here. This button represents where is the current location. So if I click on this button, it will zoom the Android application to the current location where the user is in this particular moment. Okay, so this is. Was working well before. Okay, this is where I am right now. Okay, so as you can see, we have also this button that this represents basically the layers that we can use in the map. So basically, let me click on this button, and in this button, I can like show I have already clicked. Okay, I can like select between the street view, that is the default view that we have in the Android application, but also the satellite view. So if I click on the satellite view, and see that how everything changed to basically as a trade. Okay, and then we have also like other layers here. So basically, the default one that is selected is the TI coordinates. Okay, you will see now in a moment. Okay. Okay, but we can also see, as we have selected, you know, we have set up the program stages, the symptom program stage with a coordinate, with the feature type, with a point feature type, and also we have the location of the village, that is the attribute, and we have the enrollment, so we can select all of this in the application. So I'm going to go through my presentation because this is going a bit slow. So sorry about that, but basically I think that you can follow well here as well. So these are the different buttons that we have, the map layers, that is what I was saying before. The current position that it will show, you click on this button, it will like zoom to the current position of the user. Also, when you are selecting a particular TI, you can like also navigate to it using any map application that you have installed in your device. So in this case, I have Google Maps and Maps.me. So imagine that the user is a health worker that needs to conduct an investigation for malaria, for COVID in a particular household. And then if you have recorded the household with a GPS point, then you can easily navigate to the location of the household using this button over here. Okay, so I think that this is quite useful for this kind of scenarios. So in the map layer, in this case, what we can see is that we can select the, as I said before, the vast satellite as our base map. Okay, but also we can select other different layers. By default, we are going to have the TI coordinates selected in the map, okay, as the default layer. But also we can, as I said, we can like show the enrollment coordinates, the symptoms, that in this case symptoms, you know, is a program stage of the contact registration program, okay, which feature type is point. Location of the village, because we have an attribute which value type is coordinates, and also we can show also heat maps as well. So if I am like selecting here, for instance, in the map layers, I'm selecting the TI coordinates and the location of the village. Well, in this case, it's for attributes, I have selected the location of the village. So we can see that now the TIs are being represented with, you can see this kind of a square over here, because this is the icon that represents this layer over here. So basically now these two points, GPS points, represent the location of this the location of the village of these persons, of these TIs. Okay, we can also show like different layers at the same time, of course. So like here we have like if we want to show the events, we can. At the same time, we can show the TI coordinates that are represented with a circle over here, and then the symptoms that are represented with this kind of figure, okay? So, I mean, a use case for this can be the TIs represent where the person lives, and then maybe the event, symptoms event represents where the person has been tested, okay? That can be in this particular area. Okay, so let me see if I can like now show you this sign. No, so I cannot. Okay, so I don't know if you have any questions or about the difficulties.
Jose, I have the emulator running. In case you want me to demo something, I can do it. It's working fast for me, so I think there's a problem with your screen sharing. So let me know if you want anything.
Okay, so yeah, maybe you can share the screen, Jaime. Should I stop sharing my screen? Okay, yeah, I can see your screen. So yeah, basically, okay, if you go to the control registration and follow up. Okay, and then you can like, yeah. Well, you can filter by the enrollment, the date of enrollment last month, because otherwise you are going to have. The enrollment date. The enrollment date is, yeah. And last month.
Sorry, I was muted. Sorry. I was saying that I think it's when you share, because for me it was working much faster when I'm not sharing. But yeah.
So you have the sample, okay.
You want me to do something now?
Yeah, so now, okay, so all the TIs are there. So probably if you go to the map layer, okay, so there is where, yeah, we have the then the location of the village. The location of the village is the attribute that we have set up. The symptoms, the events. So if you click on the symptoms, Jaime, as well, and maybe you can zoom in a bit, apply. Okay, so you zoom in a bit. Okay, so. Okay. So I don't know why those are black, but so basically there, you can zoom out a little bit. We can see at the same time, like TIs, the coordinates of the TIs, but also the coordinates of the where the event has been collected. Okay, so we can have like both type of coordinates layers at the same time. Okay, so basically that in the north is coordinates of the events, and the one that is in the those ones that Jaime is showing now. And if you go to the, if you zoom out a little bit and you go to the south, we can see the coordinates of the TIs. So yeah, we can combine any layer here. Yeah, and I think that's enough for the session. If there are no questions, sorry again about the difficulties. If there are no questions, maybe we can go through the exercise. Okay, so going to share my screen again. Thank you, Jaime. Okay, so the exercise, well, you have, as usual, 15 minutes to complete the exercise now. And the objectives are to know how to add coordinates to the track identity instance, okay? To know how to visualize them in the application, and to know how to use the different map layers that we were showing like 5 minutes ago. Okay. So basically what you need to do is that you need to enter 3 cases in your country city with different locations. Okay, so the program that you need to use is this one. Okay, the contact registration and follow-up program. Okay, so you need to perform data entry, do data entry on this program that everyone has access to. Okay, there is also an attribute that is an image attribute. Please, whenever you are adding, creating a new new TI, be sure that you can take a photo. Please use that attribute, because then we will actually show all the results in a map. Okay, so take a screenshot, or maybe you can add a picture from the gallery, for the gallery. But yeah, so use that attribute to collect data as well. And then you have to visualize your case in a map. And if you have like collected these attributes, so then you will see the image collected. And then you need to synchronize your case with the server. Okay, you have to do these three things. Remember to use the correct program, contact registration and follow up. And about the submission, we want to see the three screenshots of the map showing the three TIs that you have collected, okay, with the image. So this needs to be one screenshot per TI, okay? And then play a little bit with the zoom and one screenshot where all the TIs are visible in the map as well. Okay, so it should be four screenshots in total. Yeah, I don't know if it's clear or you have any questions.